viewer beware, you're in for a scare.
Rich Man Productions.
Hey YouTube, Jack coming at you with another Rich Man Production. So today I'm going to talk about books. Fuck. My phone, sorry, I've got to take this. Hello? Hello? Is anyone there? What do you mean, nice? Can you see me? Oh, shit, I've got a stalker. Wait. The joke's on you. You wanna stalk me, you're gonna see some freaky shit. Just giving you a heads up for now. Hello? Bitch, hang up! I'm sorry about that. So yeah, that stalker's gonna see some freaky shit. So anyway, yeah. Today I'm gonna talk about books. Book series in particular. You may or may not have heard of them. But, well, it begins with G, and it's a scary series. But it's aimed at children. That's right. I'm talking about Goosebumps. I've loved Goosebumps ever since I first saw it on TV and read one of the books. And yeah, it's a TV series. The books are by R.L. Stine, right there. And he's one of the best writers I've seen. I mean, he's famous for his twist endings. And recently, a friend of mine gave me loads of books. I say loads of books, I mean 8. But they are so cool. Now, first book. Which is actually the first book in the original Goosebumps series. Welcome to Dead House. This family moves into this like, new neighborhood, but things are not all what they seem. It's pretty cool. Now, some of these books have been turned into like TV episodes, which I've seen a lot of, but we don't have the books of some of them. So yeah, now that one's Welcome to Dead House. This one is Say Cheese and Die, my favourite of the entire Goosebumps collection. There's also Say Cheese and Die Again, which is a sequel. Say Cheese and Die is about this boy who finds his camera, which wants to take a picture with it. The picture isn't of the person, like, what they're doing. It's, there's loads of debate about it. It either predicts the future or causes bad things to happen. But yeah, like, say you take a picture of your friend when they're standing at the top of the stairs and like they're stationary, and the picture comes out and it shows them falling down the stairs and nearly breaking their neck. Although it's, well, it sounds like gruesome, but it's really cool. And sadly, I haven't watched that one as an episode. I watched the sequel to it, but not the book itself. But yeah. That's the second in the collection. Next one is 6th in the original series, Let's Get Invisible. It's about these this group of children who find a mirror, and once they pull the string, they can turn invisible. The strings for light on the mirror. But bad things start to happen. And it's really cool. I think they made this into an episode, but I haven't seen it. Next one, book 28. Ghost Beach. It's about these, well, this brother and sister who moved to like a beach for the summer. Stay with their aunt and uncle, and well, ghostly things happen to them. This one isn't one of my favourites, although the twist ending in this is brilliant. Phantom of the Auditorium. This one is very weird. You can just tell it's weird by the picture on the front, but yeah, it is epically weird. And this one they did make into an episode, and I did watch it. 29 in the series. Now, we move on to Series 2000, which is between 1998 and 2000. It's like newer Goosebumps books, and I didn't... If you haven't noticed, the front covers of these, the original series, have the little like, bubble things on it. That can distinguish them from the original series. Whereas the newer ones do have bubbles, but it's not the entire thing. It's like bubble around the like, title of it. Well, not the title, the word Goosebumps in Series 2000 and stuff. Then they got like a cool picture on the back. Not the front. And instead of what's normally on the back, like a little blurb description, Series 2000 has like bits of text from it. Now this one's called The Cat, or The Cry of the Cat. this is the first book in the series, and it's about this girl's running with a cat, which causes her to be stalked by it, and freaky stuff happens. And again, this has an awesome twist ending. Next, we move on to Give Yourself Goosebumps. The first series of them, they were all given this weird, like, holographic, like, shiny background sort of thing with a picture there. This one is number 7, Under the Magician's Spell. Now, Give Yourself Goosebumps is just a series where you, normal Goosebumps book, you read it and then turn over the page, and you continue reading. Give Yourself Goosebumps is a choose your own adventure one, where at the bottom of the page, like the first two or three, you would turn over to the next page. But then it gets cooler, because you would be asked to go to a like completely random page and make a choice. And depending on what choice you make, like any number of things could happen. But the annoying thing is, the Give Yourself Goosebumps books have about 15 to 20 endings, and only two of them at times are good. Sometimes there only is one good ending. And then there are pseudo good endings, which pseudo means like a sort of good, or pseudo good means sort of good but not fully good. One ending is that in one of the books you get to go home, but you're transformed into a dog. But at least you live. Sometimes you get transformed into things and then die. Sometimes you die. Sometimes you just are trapped. And then there's a possibility of you dying. But that's just really cool. Although I always get the bad endings before the good ones. And like the Magician's Spell. Not the Magician's Spell. I managed to get every single bad ending before I got a good ending. And then it was only the pseudo good ending. But yeah, that's that one. The last one is the second series of Give Yourself Goosebumps. No shiny things on the front. This is the first book in the series, Escape from the Carnival of Horrors. And, Under the Magician's Spell is where you, your sister, and your friend go into this, like, magician shop. Your sister steals a magic book. And then the magician's trying to come after you and saying that if your sister does not return the book, she'll disappear completely. Escape from the Carnival of Horrors, you're stuck in a carnival, and there is, only a few ways to get out alive. Cool endings of these, like you get eaten by a crocodile, you get killed by a scorpion, strangled by this worm creature, it's cool. Give Yourself Goosebumps, because they're supposed to be like unisex books, that means your character could either be like male or female, because it's just, it doesn't really give a gender. Sometimes they'll say he or she when you're referring to your character, but that's just a little mistake in it. But they're pretty cool. And now for the obligatory model. Again, I have no name for it. It's a clone vehicle. It's sort of like a hoverboard with wheels. Okay, this bit here is from Lego Atlantis set. These wheels from Lego Racers. Yeah, and these wheels again, like the other model, are guns. But sadly, no Racers. So yeah, it's pretty cool. Oh, and this thing here, the little seat for them, can tilt. I added it because I thought it would be cool so that if it's going like at a certain angle, trying an angle, the clone could be level. So, it's pretty cool. So yeah, this has been another Rich Man production. And Pikachu's not going to say goodbye today. Leo is. Oh, and this just to pay homage to a certain YouTuber. May the odds be ever in your favour. Goodbye.
Oh my god, look at those credits. They are so beautiful. And so sexy and shiny.
Me again, if you're watching this on Midget Models, here is a link for my other channel, BlackRose666. Here it is. Click it. You know you want to. Look at the page. Look at the page. Click it. Click it. You know you want to. Look at the page. 3, 2, 1. You're under. You will click this link. You are now not under. And the link is going. Bye-bye. In 3, 2, 2.5, 1. Now. If you haven't clicked it yet, then one last chance. Chance over. Bye.